Texas State Bobcats didn't start Sun Belt Conference play the way they hoped at a 41-21 loss at Georgia State last week. But tonight, the Bobcats are looking to bounce back as they take on the ULM Warhawks, a team also in search of its first conference win. Jones out of the shotgun motion from Luna. Jones takes a snap, quarterback draw to his right again, 30-35, far side and across midfield, 40, and goes into bounds inside the Warhawk 35 with a 34-yard line first down. Warhawks showing a blitz, handoff Mayberry, runs right at the 10, cuts back inside the 5 to the end zone for the touchdown. What an impressive run by Stebbin Mayberry. Jones with two receivers either way. Watts, slot left, goes in motion right. Here's a blitz, 5-man rush. Jones has protection, steps up, throws, pass middle, is caught. 10, 5, and down to the 3-yard line goes Watts. He sat right underneath the zone coverage and got wide open. First and goal coming up. First and goal, high snap to Jones. Keeps it himself, running left. Rock on, Tyler Jones. Touchdown, Texas State. Bobcats rushing four. Collins throws a jump ball towards end zone, and it is caught, falling on his back. Touchdown, R.J. Turner. What a throw by Will Collins. Two receivers left for Collins. No receivers, short side right. Takes a snap, back pedals to throw. Collins looks, throws right. Man is wide open inside the 5, into the end zone. Touchdown, ULM.
Came out flat in the first half. We had too many missed assignments, and like Coach says, mismatches beat you faster than like the other team, really. So we shot ourselves in the foot. You can't give up 40 points to a good team, you know, play uphill. So we got to do a better job helping our offense out and playing the first half how we played the second half.
Snap back to Collins. Here's a rush. Pass intercepted. At the 50, it's Canoe to the 40. To the 30, running right. One man to beat. 20, 15. They will not catch him today. Stan Canoe with a pick six. The Bobcats' first road interception since the 2014 season finale. Snap to the senior quarterback. Play fake. Pass over the middle. Deflected and nearly it was intercepted. Pass thrown into traffic, and on the deflection, it is Terry Osborne, the pick. Tyler Jones' third turnover tonight. ULM keeps the offense on the field, going for a fourth of the yard of the Bobcat 30-yard line. Luckett back at the formation, takes a handoff running left, and he did not get it. Bobcats stuff him at the 30-yard line, and that's a turnover on downs for Texas State's defense. Here's a handoff running left is Luckett, and the ball pops out. Davis knocked it free for Texas State, running right down the far sideline. Alexi inside the 30 to the 20, 15, 10, 5. They will not catch him today. Touchdown, Texas State, their second defensive score tonight.
And Ishmael Davis with a big forced fumble, and then Alexi has had so many big hits tonight, had an escort down the sideline. What about the Bobcat defense in fourth quarters?
In practice, Coach McCray, you know, he's a heckler for turnovers. That's the name of our defense. We're just trying to get the ball back for our offense. So 4-6, A to B, just playing hard.
Second and 2, handoff Carter, ball popped out on the ground at around the 36, and I think the quarterback Collins got back on it. Boy, a Bobcat, I believe Griffin the one, shot right through and drilled Carter. It's a loss back to the 36-yard line, and it brings up third down and 9. ULM showing a blitz again at second and 10 for the Warhawk, 45 for Jones. Ball left hash, here's the blitz. Jones a deep drop, steps up, throws a pass near side, caught by King, spins out of a tackle, crashed down to the 32-yard line for the first down at a gain of 13. It's left for Jones, no receiver, short side right. Takes a snap, Jones gonna keep it himself, up the middle, 10, 5, dives end zone, rock on Tyler Jones, touchdown Texas State. 40-34 ULM, 41 seconds to go, Bobcats the ball, thrown 31. King comes in motion left to right. Jones takes a snap, rolls right, looking left now, throws back to Schrade, breaks a tackle at the 30, running left, 35, and tackled it around the 41-yard line by Griffith, but a first down, moves the chains and stops the clock for a moment. Now to 25 seconds, Jones steps up, looks, Tyler goes middle, pass caught by Schrade, inside of ULM territory and down to the ULM 40, 17 seconds. Jones out of the gun, trips right, one receiver to his left. Here's a 5-man rush. Jones steps up, pass to his side, caught by King, goes out of bounds with 4 seconds to go at the ULM 32-yard line. Trips right for Jones. One receiver left. ULM at three-man line. They're going to rush four. Jones rolls to his right. Kind of buy time. Throws the ball deep towards the end zone. Jump ball. It is incomplete. No flags. This ball game is over.
It's not an effort thing. It never has been an effort thing with our football team. It's an execution thing. It's a focus thing. And you know, I'll take my team over any other team in a tug of war, you know, because we're never going to give up. We're never going to give it. And we're always going to fight. We have to execute better in situations that are imperative to execute.
Hard-fought game. Thought our kids competed. Again, a little bit like last week. We didn't play well in the first half at times. And then we come out and we play pretty well in the second half. So we got to figure out how to play well for 60 minutes instead of just 30 minutes.
We stop ourselves. And there are things that we do that we're not supposed to do that make them look good. They played really, really hard, and they're a hit or miss defense with all the blitzes and all the stunts that they do. So they had some hits on us, and there was also some opportunities that we didn't take advantage of early. And we have to go back at the film and look at those things and improve. It's a long season, and for the most part, we've got a very young team, and it's you know, you have the ups and downs and like the really fast and then not so much, and that comes from being able to control your emotions. And execute your job no matter what's going on. And that's something that we need to do better as a team. And that's just playing games and playing football and being in these types of things, because I'm heartbroken right now.
We're not into boundaries because curiosity is endless. We're not perfect. We don't expect you to be. Together we'll grow and learn and build a bigger you, a stronger you. Texas State University, a better you.
At Pizza Hut, we've got a carryout deal just for you. Any pizza, any size, any crust, and any topping for just $10. You want a large hand-tossed pepperoni and mushroom? $10. Or maybe you're a large pan supreme kind of person? $10. Thinking about a combination of your own? Well, that's $10 too. That's any pizza, any size, any crust, and any topping for just $10. And get stuffed crust for just $2 more. This $10 carryout deal ends soon, so hurry to Pizza Hut today.
My fellow Americans, they say we're a nation divided.
That's not true. We agree on a lot.
Like Paul Rudd. Everybody loves Paul Rudd.
I didn't know this was gonna happen.
You know what else everyone loves?
Emojis.
No beer!
That's why we're forming the Bud Light Party. Just wait till you see our caucus.
We got the biggest caucus in the country.
Woo-wee! I'm really inspired right now.
America has seen the light.
And there's a bud in front of it.
After going back and watching tape, it's funny, you get back at whatever time we got back, 6 o'clock in the morning. I came back up here about 8:30 Sunday morning, just so I watched part of it on the bus, watched part of it Sunday morning, and you know, a couple things come real crystal clear to you. We got a young football team. And When I say that, what I mean is, and I'm gonna be a little bit long-winded, what I mean is the moment sometimes can get too big for guys. And then what I mean by too big for them is you can coach them, you can drill it, you can do it, but when they have to get out there and do it, sometimes it doesn't get done. And there was a play, and I'll give you one instance. There's a We stop them, get the ball back for offense. We go punt return. They give us a tight formation. We got two freshmen on our punt block team that are supposed to hold up two guys. All week long, they've held up the right guys. On Saturday, they hold up the wrong guy. And then we've got a punt returner that's a junior that in our punt return scheme, the ball is supposed to go right back where it's kicked from, meaning if the ball is kicked from the hash, that's our return, we're taking down the hash. He tries to take it to the field, and we get a holding penalty, which moves us back, which means we got longer to go to try to drive for the last score. So there's a lot of little things, but that one play had two instances in it where guys don't do what they're coached. And is it frustrating? Yes, but it's also youth and guys that still have to learn how to buy into your program. And when you have, we always talk about three things in your program. You either have guys that can't do it, guys that won't do it, or guys that don't know how to do it yet. And we've got some that can't, and that's recruiting. That's recruiting. You got some that won't, and to me that's the defiance. And I don't think we have many guys that won't. I don't think we have any guys, to be honest with you, that won't. And then you have some guys that just they can't take the meeting to the field yet. And that's where we got to get better as a football team, taking the meeting to the field. So I spent a lot of time with the defensive staff going over the film and actually going back and looking at practice film and looking at notes and tips and reminders and seeing stuff that was included in tips and reminders. We had our inside linebackers, Gabe Lloyd and Brian London, didn't play very well at all. And I went back and I looked at Coach McCray's tips and reminders, and in his tips and reminders, number tip 8 said, key the tight end in the run game. And probably 20 times in the run game, they didn't key the tight end in the run game. So that's kind of where we are as a football team right now. We've got to lock in. The word of the week was focus. Obviously, we didn't for the entire game. So we've got to continue to get better at that. You can't give up 23 points in the second quarter. You can't turn it over two times in the second quarter when they're not good turnovers. They're not, you know, tip balls. All, you know, they're bad decisions. You can't give up 298 yards of net rushing to anybody and expect to win. But I will say, you know, the team kept battling back. There were five balls on the ground that we didn't get Saturday, that the other team laid on the ground that we didn't get Saturday. So somehow, some way, we got to find a way to get two of those. We did get two turnovers that gave us points. So defense did some good things in that fashion.
Honestly, in the locker room before the game, we were all talking about no more falling on balls. Last week we fell on, or 2 weeks ago we fell on three balls, and that we could have scooped and scored. And in the locker room, we were just talking about, hey, you see a ball on the ground, you scoop it up and score it. And so like it kind of like the talk before the game came to fruition. So that was a pretty cool deal. First off, we had some great push by the defensive line. I didn't have to do much on that play except for get off a block. Ishmael Davis, number 42, he did the rest. They got the running back in the backfield and stripped him, and I was just right there in the right place, right time to pick it up. And we always talking about we need to score on defense, so I was happy I had the opportunity to help the team out with that.
I thought we ran the ball a little bit better on offense than we have. It's still not close to what we have to be to be successful. I thought our quarterback ran the ball better. I thought he, and again, that's a big part of our offense. Our quarterback has to have a piece of the run game in our offense, and I thought he did a really good job of that. So we are making some strides, and again, if you go back and you turn your pages back to maybe 2 months ago at a press conference, you'll see that we try to gauge this thing as a season. It's steady growth in the program, and wins and losses are important, but for right now, they're not the most important thing for this program right now. The most important thing is we continue to get better. Our program's about fighting your way out of adversity. I mean, it is. Everything we do is about fighting your way out of adversity. And we've got to grow up and learn how. You learn how to win. You know, I really believe that. You just don't win. You learn how to win. And one of the things we got to do better as coaches, we got to teach our guys how to win. You know, our our football team's got to learn how to, you know, if it's sudden change, boy, how to go attack the field on defense and get a stop. And we've done that some. We've gone on the field in plus territory and stopped and make people kick field goals. We haven't done it enough, and we're having to do it too much. So we've got to find a way to fight adversity. And that, to me, is playing the game. You know, guys get more snaps and playing the game.
We're the Four Escobars, and this is our sauce. Four Escobars barbecue sauce is definitely a family business. It was created right in my kitchen. My 10-year-old son even helped design the label. And then everyone I knew started asking for gallons of it. When H-E-B named it as a Quest for Texas Best finalist, I knew it was something special. Now our sauces are in H-E-Bs everywhere. Having H-E-B support has been great for our business and Texas barbecue. We're the Four Escobars, and this is the best in Texas department at H-E-B.
Look for these and other great Primo picks at H-E-B.
At Pizza Hut, we've got a carryout deal just for you. Any pizza, any size, any crust, and any topping for just $10. You want a large hand-tossed pepperoni and mushroom? $10. Or maybe you're a large pan supreme kind of person? $10. Thinking about a combination of your own? Well, that's $10 too. That's any pizza, any size, any crust, and any topping for just $10. And get stuffed crust for just $2 more. This $10 carryout deal ends soon, so hurry to Pizza Hut today.
We're going to play a team this week, much like the last two teams we played. The record doesn't indicate how talented they are. They've got a very talented team. They lost to a very talented Appalachian State team. I hope you guys understand it's Appalachian and not Appalachian. I had to correct the guy on the radio last night because he called it Appalachian State. That's my alma mater, so it's called Appalachian State. So I had to correct him. So they lost to a very tough Appalachian State University team last week. This program has been one of the premier programs in the Sun Belt. I know they've had some issues with some NCAA stuff here recently, but they've had 4 years where they've done really, really well in this conference. Running backs very talented. They've got good size up front in the offensive line. Even though they're struggling in the passing game, they run the ball very well. Their defense is a lot like Georgia State as far as length and size. We kind of compare them to Georgia State's defense in a lot of ways, the way they play. They will bring more pressure than any team we played. They're about 40% pressure. And at least five guys attacking the line of scrimmage. So we've got a big challenge ahead of us. Again, the growth this week that we need to make is needed. We need to get better at we play a little bit better in the offensive line. We got to get better in the offensive line. We need to play better stopping the run on defense to give us a chance. We won't have any chance if we can't stop the run. So we've got to fit the run a lot better at all of our front seven positions for us to have a chance to win the ball game.
They like to run the ball. They love running the ball. I feel like we have to stop the run. We have to make sure that we have a physical presence on the run every time we get a chance to. We got to get as many hats around the ball and on the running backs that they rotate in, especially McGuire. And I feel like if we play gap sound responsible football and stop the run, and then we'll have a good chance to get him on third and long and get off the field. You definitely do remember specific players, specific plays that happened in years past, and you see it, you see some players that you remember on film and stuff, and you're like, oh, I can't wait to get back at it and compete against them another year, you know, and I have another chance at getting the W against them.
Party is going to address the issues that matter.
We are going to bring America together. Hard.
It's a party for everyone. Men.
Yeah. Women.
Woo! People of all genders.
But, you know, gender identity, it's really a spectrum, and we don't need these labels.
Beer should have labels, not people.
Kablam! Yeah.
We don't care. We'll sell you beer.
We'll sell you a beer any day of the week. Yeah.
Tight hands, tight elbows, hairline below the chin. That's important today. That's the one thing I need you to work on today. Hairline below the chin, everything you do. Same with you, 8. Hairline below the chin, 8. All day. All right, if he doesn't declare someone else on him, that's yours. Understood? Here we go. Let's go, Waddy! Waddy! Not a walkthrough! Get to the third man, right? 1, 2, 3. Ah, cut! Cut! Pad level, pad level. Good. Ready, ready. Keep your feet, keep your feet. Cut! Good, that's better, 7. Ready, ready. He's gonna do this, boom. That's a tackle, and you have a C-gap fit. That's what we talked about pre-practice. Yeah. That. Good. Good. That's going to be your fit. Again, you're fitting off of them. Set. What gap? What gap? Why? Good. Here we go. Here we go. Set. Come on. Hop. Stop hopping. Stop hopping. I'm reading my tackle. He goes down, okay. My eyes gotta go here. My hands gotta go here. Okay, so I can win that gap. All right, once, listen, here's what I need you guys to understand. Once he goes down and he's blocking me, I'm doing whatever I can to win that gap. All right, whatever I can to win this gap.
Make sure to show your love and follow the Bobcats on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and their YouTube channel.
How do you show your Bobcat pride? Now you can show it off and keep your money here at Texas State. Because whenever you buy at the University Bookstore at Texas State, that money stays here on campus. Apparel, books, gifts, and much more. Online or in the heart of Bobcat country, find it, get it, and keep it on campus. University Bookstore at Texas State, your bookstore.
River. Welcome back to The Path. The Bobcats looking to snap a two-game losing streak this Saturday and look for their first conference win of the season when they play their first Sun Belt home game of the year against the visiting Raging Cajuns. For more on Saturday's game, we're joined up with the phone by Jay Walker from the Raging Cajuns radio network. Now, Jay, the Cajuns have had their own struggles so far this season. They're 2-4 on a three-game losing streak going into Saturday's game, but two of those losses did come in multiple overtimes. Now that the Cajuns have hit the halfway point of their season, what do you make of this football team?
Well, it's a team that has, I think, struggled to have an offensive identity. They've turned the ball over too much. They've had some guys get banged up. You know, the four overtime loss against Tulane, they turned it over four times inside the 25-yard line. Game against New Mexico State, they did it basically without Elijah McGuire, and they threw a pick six. They're really close to being 4-2 right now, but the reality is they're 2-4, and I think that this team is lacking an awful lot of confidence right now.
Jay, let's break down the Cajuns' offense even further. Anthony Jennings, the LSU transfer, has struggled at quarterback, but in the backfield, the Cajuns have one of the more explosive playmakers in the Sun Belt in running back Elijah McGuire. What is it going to take for this offense to get things back on track?
Well, first of all, Eli needs to get healthy. You know, he's going to be close to 100% this weekend. You know, he hasn't been himself really since the Tulane game, which was game four of the season. That's the first thing. And that would take a little bit of the pressure off Jennings. And the offensive line needs to play better. They just have not done a good job protecting Jennings. And that's been a big issue for the Cajuns as well. So a healthy Eli and a better performance by the offensive line makes Jennings better, and that makes the offense better.
Let's look now at the defense. The Cajuns are second in the Sun Belt in stopping the run, first in the conference in sacks as well, and have one of the best linebacking groups in all of the conference. Looking at this defense, what's impressed you so far this season?
Well, you know, as a lot of people know, they made a change in defensive coordinator after the first game, and Mike Lucas came in and has done a very, very good job, and they've gone more to a four-man front now as opposed to the 3-4. They'll still play the 3-4, but they've made it a point to keep people from running the football, and overall they've done a very good job. Now, you know, they've given up a lot of yards passing, and I think that secondary's got some issues. But the front seven's been good, and you know, you certainly can't blame this record on the Cajuns' defense after the first game, because overall they've played pretty well.
Jay, now focusing on the matchup this Saturday between the Bobcats and the Cajuns, both teams come in 2-4, desperate to stop the bleeding this weekend. It is worth noting the Cajuns have had the Bobcats number since Texas State entered the Sun Belt 3 years ago. Looking at the matchup this Saturday, what kind of game are you expecting to see?
You know what? It's a very good question, and it's a question I don't have an answer to. I think the Bobcats haven't been a very good matchup because I think the Cajuns just had so many more athletes. They were just so much more athletic. And I think Coach Withers is changing that. I see more athleticism on this team than I've seen in the past. It's a very, very young team. But I got to tell you, when Texas State made the announcement that they were hiring Coach Withers, my first response was, uh-oh, because he's one of the guys that I think can come in this league and build a winner and do it relatively quickly. You know, they lost a lot of players, and you're always going to have some attrition when a new coach comes in. And as a result, you know, they've got some issues. But I think both of these teams are capable of moving the football. Both of these teams are capable of scoring points. I don't think either one of these teams is going to scare anybody defensively except the Cajuns in the running game. You know, I think these are two teams in desperate need of a win, but I got to tell you, I think Texas State made the right hire. You know, you can go ahead and buy yourself a portable building, or you can build a building with a great foundation. I think Coach Withers is doing that.
Thanks to Jay, and that's going to do it for this week's episode of The Path. I'm Brant Freeman, reminding you that this party in the end zone, it's just getting started. We'll see you next time.